Okay, so dito na tayo sa administrative sanctions ng RA 5487 sa kanyang implementing rules and regulations or kanyang IRR. Asa na? Ayun. Readable ba? Readable naman, no? Okay. So, part 1, general. Section 1 states the policy. Corollary to Section 2, PD 1919, the Chief PNP or his authorized representative may impose, after confirming any violation of this law, its amendments, and IRR, the penalty of suspension or cancellation of the license or accreditation of any private or government security or training personnel, provided that in cases of violations committed by any private security or detective agency, company guard force, or private security training institution, the administrative penalty which may be imposed shall only be administrative fine or cancellation of license without prejudice to any criminal action against the violator. So this means that licenses given to security agencies, pati na rin yung sa mga security guards natin or private detectives, are privileges. This means na pwedeng alisin sa'yo ang lisensya mo. Katulad na kahit anong lisensya, our licenses are government property. Say, driver's license. Kaya pwede nilang kunin yon. Especially kung meron kang nalabag na batas. Kaya nga, di ba, pag may nahuhuli na may violation sa pagmamaneho niya, pwedeng kunin ang lisensya. Kasi nga, your license is not your personal property. Dala mo lang. Pero property yan ng gobyerno, kaya pwede niyang kunin. Yun na nga, kung may nalabag kang batas. So, ang sinasabi din dito na ang ipapatulang naman na parusa is administrative. Administrative penalty. Maliban na lang kung talagang may nagawang criminal na paglabag sa batas. May crime talaga siyang nagawa. O syempre, ibang kaso yun. Okay. Ano ang purpose? The purpose of these rules and regulations is to rationalize the schedule of administrative penalties. Okay. So, sanctions against licensed security personnel. So, ano yung mga pwedeng ipataw na parusa doon sa mismong tao na nagpa-practice ng kanyang profession bilang isang security person? So, classification offenses. The following terms shall be construed to mean as indicated, which shall likewise refer to the individual person as private security or security training personnel. So, light offenses shall include but not limited to those related to uniforms, except for those falling under paragraph C1 here under. So, kapag may hindi tamang pagsuot ng kanyang uniforme or malala, hindi naka-uniforme. Use of profane languages, bawal yun. Acts of discourteousness, bastos ka. Failure to notify or call the nearest PNP station in case of disorders, riots, or strikes, and other emergency cases. Kasi kapag may ganun, nabanggit natin sa mga past lectures natin, kailangan tumawag ka sa police or sa bombero o kung kanino mang agency or government agency or office na dapat mag-ayos doon sa kaguluhan. Okay, yun ang trabaho mo, tumawag. And then late or failure to maintain or submit records and reports, kasi ang mga yan, kailangan, na-distract ako. So yung mga yan, kailangan on time na ipapasa kasi may sinusunod na schedule yan. Tsaka, kung may kailangan kang ibigay ng instruction sa kapalitan mo o doon sa iyong supervisor, kailangan mabigay mo yun agad para may continuity yung pagpapatupad ng mga instructions na nare-receive mo. Violation of Section 1, Rule 10 of these rules and regulations, otherwise not specifically falling under this and paragraphs B and C of this rule, All acts prejudicial to good conduct, behavior, morals, and similar acts pursuant to existing laws, rules, and regulations. Then less grave offenses shall include but not limited to not having in possession his or her license to exercise profession, duty detail order, and or firearms license when carrying firearms while performing private security service. So, nasaan ka man, habang duty ka, kailangan bit-bit mo ang lisensya mo. Parang sa driver's license lang, di ka pwede magmaneho kung wala kang dalang lisensya. Kahit pa na talagang legit na may lisensya ka, tapos naiwan mo lang sa bahay mo, sabihin natin, naiwan mo lang. Hindi ka pa rin pwede magmaneho. Kasi yun nga yung nagbibigay sa'yo ng karapatan para magmaneho yung actual, as in yung physical na lisensya mo. So, ganun din sa mga private security guards natin o yung mga nagpo-provide ng security services. At lalo na, kung ikaw ay may dalang baril, syempre kailangan dala mo yung LTAP mo. Okay? And then, use of uniform not appropriate for one's ranks or position. Parang sa pulis din. Kung ikaw, ang ranggo mo ay patrolman, hindi ka pwede magsuot ng uniforme na nakalagay, corporal. Bawal yon. So, less grave offense na yon. Okay? And then, number three, leaving his post without being properly relieved, thus exposing the lives and properties he is supposed to protect from danger. Kung maalala ninyo, may nagtanong nito nung huli. So, yun talaga kasi ang rule. Hindi ka pwedeng umalis sa post mo kung wala kang kapalitan. Okay? And then, indiscriminate firing of firearm not in connection with the performance of duty. Nagpaputok ka ng baril, hindi naman dapat. Less grave offense yun. Other similar offenses pursuant to existing laws, rules, and regulations. And then we have grave offenses. This shall include but likewise not limited to using uniform other than that prescribed under these rules, using personally owned or unlicensed firearm during the tour of duty. Bawal yun. Allowing the use or lending issued firearms to unauthorized persons. May inisyo sa iyo na baril ang company mo. Pinahiram mo. Pinaupa mo sa iba. Bawal yun. Assisting, abetting, or protecting criminals during or off duty. Siyempre. Aiding and abetting ang kaso mo doon. Then providing confidential information to unauthorized persons. Kung maalala ninyo, isa sa mga katangian na dapat mataglay ng isang security officer or security guard or security personnel is loyalty and confidentiality to the agency he is serving. Kung confidential yan, what you see, what you hear, when you live, leave it here. Hindi mo siya pwede i-chismis. Okay? And then, refusal to provide information to authorized persons. Yung kanina, bawal kang magmarites sa mga hindi naman authorized. Pero pwede kang magmarites sa mga authorized, lalo na kung hinihingi sa'yo at kailangan talaga yung impormasyon na yon para sa pag... para makapagtrabaho kayo ng maayos. Okay? And then, illegal search. Siyempre, illegal nga eh. Di bawal. Then, taking alcoholic beverages or being drunk while on guard duty. Nabanggit na natin noon na ang isang security guard or security personnel dapat laging alerto while on duty. Paano ka magiging alerto kung lasing ka? Paano ka magiging alerto kung may hangover ka pa o nagsashot ka? Yun ang malala, nag-shot ka pa doon sa mismong duty mo, di ba? Abuse or acting beyond the scope of authority. Alam naman ng security personnel kung hanggang saan lang ang otoridad nila at hindi sila pwede lumagpas doon. Kung ano lang yung trabaho, yun lang ang dapat nilang gawin. Misrepresentation in the submission of documents for renewal of license. Baka nagpasa ka ng mga peking documents para lang ma-renew yung license mo. Siyempre, bawal. Other similar offense, pursuant to existing laws, rules, and regulations. Fake license. It is a document issued by and or secured from sources other than the SAGS-D. Kasi SAGS-D lang ang may karapatan mag-issue niyan ng lisensya. At kapag hindi galing sa kanila, ma-take fake. Fake yun. Galing ka pala sa University of Recto, di ba? Section 4, penalties. Without prejudice to the filing of the appropriate criminal action, the following penalties shall be imposed after investigation of any private security personnel thereafter found guilty of committing any of the offenses previously enumerated in Section 3 of this rule. So for light offenses, 1 to 30 day suspension or a fine ranging from 100 pesos to 500 pesos maximum. For less grave offenses, 1 month to one month and 1 day to 6 months suspension or a fine from 500 pesos minimum to 1,000 pesos maximum or both. Tandaan nyo to ha. Katulad lang din sa ibang batas na napag-aralan na natin, kailangan may distinction. Kaya dito sa light offenses, hanggang 30 days lang. So, 1 month. So sa grave, less grave offenses naman, 1 month and 1 day. Yun naman. And then for grave offenses, 6 months and 1 day to 1 year suspension or a fine ranging from 10,000 pesos minimum to 50,000 pesos maximum or both and or cancellation of license or permit. So dito, pwede ka nang alisan ng lisensya kapag nakagawa ka ng isang grave offense. Okay. Section 5. Status during suspension. Unless dismissed by his employer, pag sinabing dismissed, inalis ka na, sinisante ka, agents, employer agency on legal grounds, a security guard who is suspended, pursuant hereto, dito sa batas na to, shall not be entitled to receive his salary corresponding to the period of suspension. So when you are suspended, wala ka rin sahod. The agency in this case shall provide a substitute guard to man the post of the suspended guard in order not to prejudice the interest of its client. Hindi pwedeng walang papalit doon. Kung maalala ninyo, isa yan sa advantage ng mga agency guards kasi madaling makahanap ng karelyebo. Lalo na kung ganyan, may mga nasuspende na lisensya. Okay. Provided the service of the substitute guard shall be good only during the period of such suspension. So, kumbaga, nagre-report lang siya habang suspended yung isa. Pero kapag na-lift na yung suspension, paalis na rin siya. Palit lang kasi, di ba? Nag-substitute nga lang siya. Okay. Any private security personnel who commits the same offense as enumerated in Section 3 above after having been suspended for at least 3 times within the lifetime of his license shall be cancelled. So, may maximum ang lisensya mo. Kumbaga, may hangganan. Kung ikaw ay nakatatlong beses nang nasuspende, aalisin na sa'yo yung lisensya mo. Sobrang dami mo namang nagawa para masuspend. Eh, di ba, ang suspension dito lang sa grave offense. So, nakatatlong grave offense ka, alis ka na talaga ng lisensya. Kumbaga, sobrang chance na yun na ibigay sa'yo. Okay, and then part 3, sanctions against private security agencies, private detective agencies, company guard forces, and or training institutions. Section 7, the authority of the chief PNP to impose administrative penalties or cancel, suspend, or not to renew the license of any private security, detective agency, company guard force, and or private security training institutions shall be exercised in the following cases without prejudice to the filing of appropriate criminal action. First is when a falsified license is officially submitted by a private security agency to its prospective client in bidding or contracting for security services. Nagbigay ka ng pekeng dokumento, pekeng lisensya doon sa kliyente or sa prospective client mo. So si Chief PNP, pwede kanyang patawan ng administrative penalties or i-cancel or i-suspend o hindi na i-re-renew yung lisensya mo bilang isang security guard or security agency. Ano pa yung ibang pagkakataon? When a falsified document or report is submitted to the PNP as requirement for new or renewal of license to operate a private security agency, company, security force, or training institution. Kapag nagbigay ka nga ng peking document para sa renewal nyo rin ng lisensya nyo. When a private security agency or company security force has been found to be violating the minimum wage rates fixed by law that should be granted to their private security or company guards. So kapag mas mababa ang pasahod mo kumpara sa minimum wage sa lugar, kasi iba ang minimum wage sa Manila, di ba? Tsaka dito sa probinsya. So, regardless, basta below minimum wage ang pasahod, pwede kang isuspend or alisan ng lisensya ni Chief PNP. Then, when the private security agency or company security force has been found to be engaging in activities that are dangerous to public safety and welfare or inimical to national security. Kapag gumagawa naman kayo ng mga kalokohan, kapag gumagawa kayo ng mga bagay na, yun nga, dangerous to public safety and welfare or inimical to national security. Then, when a private security agency or company security force refuses to comply with the final and executory NLRC order or decision, this will be a ground for immediate revocation of license to operate. And then, violation of the following rules and regulations, Section 2B, 4, 3A, 3B, 3C, 3H of Rule 4, Section 1 and 2 of Rule 4. When a private security agency has been found to have engaged in cutthroat security services with its client or a price lower than the standard minimum rates for security services adopted by the Pampanga Association of Detective and Protective Agency Operators or PADPAW, yan yung PADPAW, with the occurrence of concurrence of the Chief PNP. A penalty of administrative fine shall be imposed upon such erring security private security agency in the amount of 20,000 for first offense, 40,000 second offense, and cancellation of license to operate for third offense. Parang sa lisensya lang din ng security guard, di ba? Kapag third offense na, aalisan na siya ng lisensya. Dito naman, sa security agency, third offense, aalisan na ng lisensya. In case of fines, the erring PSA shall not be allowed to serve the questioned client. PSA operators whose licenses has been cancelled under this rule shall be barred from obtaining another LPO. When a private security agency has been found to have violated Section 4, Rule 7, a penalty of administrative fine shall be imposed upon the erring private security agency. When a private security agency has been found to have violated Section 3CG Rule 10, a penalty of administrative fines will be imposed upon such private security agency, and then same lang din, 20,000 first offense, 40,000 second, then cancellation of license a third. In case of fines, the erring PSA, private security agency, shall not be allowed to serve the questioned client. PSA operators whose licenses has been cancelled under this rule shall be barred from obtaining another license to operate. Hindi yan Land Transportation Office, ha? When a private security agency with regular license to operate fails to maintain a minimum of 200 security guards at the time of renewal of its license, the agency concerned shall be issued temporary license with an administrative fine in the amount of 10,000 pesos only. So, hindi pwede na mas mababa sa 200 ang security guard mo. Mapipenalty ka. Violation of its provisions of Rule 18 by private security personnel is punishable by suspension or cancellation of their individual private security licenses and or licenses of their respective company security force or private security agencies. Then the following administrative fine shall be imposed on any private security agency or company security force found committing the following offenses: improper wearing of prescribed uniform by posted security personnel, 100 pesos per guard. Kung lahat ng tao mo mali ang hindi tama ang pagsusuot nila ng uniform, 100 kada tao yun. Eh kung 200 yun. First offense yun. 250, second offense, 500, third offense. Posted security guard not carrying his ID, di ba? Requirement yun na ang isang security guard dapat laging suot ang kanyang ID. Private security license dapat dala niya. And then firearms license, kung meron siyang baril na dala, kailangan dala niya rin yung lisensya niya para doon. Then duty detail order, yun yung sinasabi na duty siya sa oras na to. Yun yun, duty detail. Posted security personnel not covered or by written contract for security services. Hindi siya parte ng company, wala siyang kontrata, tapos pinag-duty mo siya doon sa company. Bawal. Parehas lang ng fine. Imposing and collecting unauthorized deductions from the salary of their security guard. Yung mga hindi naman talaga covered ng ano to, benefits, tapos nagbabawas ka sa sahod nila, bawal yan. Then failure to submit application and requirements for the renewal of license or on prescribed date, 250 plus 54 every day delayed, if filed before expiration of LTO. An addition of 500 pesos plus 100 for every day delay, not to exceed 60 days if filed after expiration of LTO. Okay. And then, Section 9, classification of offenses. Except in cases already specifically provided in this rule, the following term shall be construed to mean as indicated: light offenses committed by private security agency or company security force shall include, but not limited to, ulit-ulit lang, parehas lang to halos kanina, late or failure to maintain and or submit records and reports, posting security personnel not covered by written contract, nagpa-duty ka, wala naman siyang kontrata, other similar offense pursuant to existing laws, rules, and regulations. Pag less grave offense naman, ordering its posted security guards to conduct illegal search, inutusan mo pang mag-conduct ng illegal search. Posting. Pag sinabing posting, hindi nagpa-skill ha. Posting, naglagay ka ng tao. So, posting unlicensed personnel for duty. Kunwari, ako, wala naman akong lisensya para sa pagiging security guard, tapos pinag-duty mo ako dyan bilang isang security guard, hindi pwede yon. Posted personnel not wearing the prescribed uniform and similar offense pursuant to existing laws, rules, and regulations. And then, grave offense committed by private security agencies or company guard force, security force, allowing the set of unlicensed firearm personally owned by security guard or other person or entity than that of the private security agency having jurisdiction of the place being secured. Ibig sabihin, ang pwede lang dalhin talaga na lisensya ng isang security guard ay yung issue ng kanyang company. Kapag personal yan, tapos hindi pa lisensyado, hindi pwede yun, syempre. Issuing unlicensed firearm to guards. Nagbigay ka nga ng baril sa mga guard mo kung ikaw ay security agency. Wala namang mga lisensya yung baril. Paso yung lisensya. Hindi rin pwede yun. And then, violation of Section 3H, Rule 4 of this implementing rules. And regulations regarding prohibition on kabit system. Abuse or acting beyond the scope of authority. Kasi nga, di ba, napag-usapan natin na may jurisdiction ang trabaho ng isang security guard. At dahil nga yun ang jurisdiction mo, hindi ka pwedeng lumagpas doon sa kung ano ang aktwal na dapat mong gawin o dapat mong ibigay na serbisyo sa isang kliyente. Use and or employment of security guard for purposes of committing threats, intimidation, coercion, or any other crime or offenses including show of force. Ginamit mo pa yung security guard para takutin ang iba, para mang-intimidate o para pilitin ang iba na gawin yung gusto mo. Grave offense yun. Then violation of sections 3A, 3B, 3C of Rule 10 and other similar offense pursuant to existing laws, rules, and regulations. Then, Section 10, penalties. Without prejudice to the filing of appropriate criminal action and except as already provided in this by this rule, the following penalties shall be imposed after investigation of any guard or detective, private security guard agency, or company security force, and therefore found guilty of committing any of the offenses enumerated in Section 9. So for light offenses committed by private security agency or company security force, first offense, 5,000, second offense, 10,000, then cancellation or revocation of license to operate, or 15,000 pesos for third offense, or both. For less grave offense, 10,000 pesos ang first offense, 20,000 ang second offense, 30,000 pesos ang third offense, or cancellation or revocation of license to operate, or both. For grave offense, first offense is 50,000. Second offense is cancellation or revocation of license to operate. Wala nang third offense kasi grave na ito. Imagine nyo, nagdala ka ng mga security guard para ibully yung isang tao, para i-coerce ang isang tao. Talagang alisan ka dapat ng lisensya, di ba? Second offense pa lang. And then, Section 11, any private security agency or company security force who commits the same offense as enumerated in Section 8 hereof, after having been fined at least 3 times, shall be proceeded against through administrative cancellation or non-renewal of its license. Hindi ka na makakauli sa business na yan. Ayun.